The stock market rally has its days counted, and the substantial drop seen over the past few weeks suggests that the catalyst for an epic crash is rising inflation. The U.S. is experiencing the worst inflation surge in nearly four decades, and the Federal Reserve is facing mounting pressure to start tapering its bond purchasing programs and hiking interest rates over the next 2 weeks. In normal times, those measures could cause some serious economic damage, but these are not normal times. These are crazy times, and the risks have never been higher. For months, market insiders have been warning that this is effectively the biggest stock market bubble in history. And now that the burst has begun, the situation is particularly precarious. The tech sector has already witnessed some sharp losses, but right before the market closed on Friday, the meltdown was becoming more widespread. The Shiller price-to-earnings index is also signaling that the current bubble surpasses the 1929 bubble and is nearing the record set right before the 2000 dot-com crash. In fact, in a recent note to clients, Market Analysis with Richard Bernstein Associates listed five indications of a looming market bubble burst, and it's safe to say that we can see each one of them in the current stock market. Sure, for a long time now, analysts, experts, economists, and investors have been sounding the alarm about an explosive and sudden stock market crash that would wipe out billions in earnings overnight. And even though the collapse of the bubble has already started, we're still hearing silence. Investors desperately want to believe that this is just a downward trend that will be over soon. But once they realize what is really going on, it might be too late, and we'll start hearing panic screams. Bernstein's five horsemen of the market apocalypse expose the truth most people don't want to face, that only a miracle could reverse this trend. The first indicator of this inevitable downfall is liquidity. The Fed stimulus has increasingly been trapped within the financial markets and fueled speculation rather than healthy economic activity, the firm's analysts wrote. Over the past 2 years, the money supply has expanded enormously, and those trillions of printed dollars helped to create some of the economic and financial imbalances we're seeing in our system. Government stimulus has disproportionately ballooned towards stocks, pushing prices to record levels. But now that a liquidity crunch is near, those inflated valuations can't stay high on their own, and stocks are set to a sizable correction. Number two is leverage. The number of investors borrowing to play the market and keep fueling the bubble is simply unprecedented. The last time we witnessed this level of investor euphoria, things did not end well. According to a Magnify Money survey, 40% of individual investors overall, including 80% of Generation Z investors and 60% of millennials, are buying stocks with borrowed money. A very bold and dangerous move, considering how big are the risks to lose it all and leave the rally with a painful debt. That leads us to the third indicator, amateurs. In Bernstein's view, despite the associated noble intentions, every financial bubble includes a democratization of the market. Everyone should get to play, the firm notes. Now, the growth of internet groups focused on investments, the emergence of easy-to-use trading platforms, and the extraordinary performance of meme and junk stocks prove that the current speculative fervor includes everyone, it added. Number four is IPOs. Stock buying manias help bring down the cost of capital, and artificially suppressed interest rates have definitely played a part in that. The surge in special purpose acquisition companies, SPACs or SPACs, which are easy ways to go public with less regulatory scrutiny, have enabled low profit companies to enter the market. And not all of them will be able to justify their stock valuations compared to their real prospects of growth. That's what happened to automaker Rivian, whose stock price collapsed by over 50% since the burst began. Last but not least, trading. The Bernstein Report reminds how day traders boosted trading volume during the technology bubble and flipping condos spurred turnover during the housing bubble. Now we're in the era of meme stock traders that have been pouring giant piles of money into shares of bankrupt companies. But a reality check is fast approaching. As Bernstein warned, a series of unprofitable stock market superstars from the tech world is hanging by a thread, and this seems like deja vu all over again. An 80% crash is not out of the picture, as explained by the 48-year market veteran David Hunter. The coming meltdown is going to look a lot like the 2000s tech bubble burst, when thousands of internet companies fell spectacularly. One major example of it was the profitless company Pets.com, which had a big ad buy during the Super Bowl back then and was bankrupt 11 months later. Today, the leading tech stocks belonging to companies that have been in the red for most of the past 3 years. According to Bernstein tech analyst Tony Sacconaghi and his team, these stocks are likely to sink even further in the coming weeks. In a fresh report, Sacconaghi said that some earnings-free companies, such as Pinterest, social media Snap, data analysis software maker Palantir Technologies, and cybersecurity provider CrowdStrike Holdings, are in the firm's watch list. Today, more than a third of all unprofitable tech stocks trade at greater than 15 times revenues, Sacconaghi wrote in a client note. Tech names with such high multiples and no earnings historically have shown returns that are very poor, he continued. The problem is that these stocks can only climb as long as growth stocks are climbing too. This means that things can go badly very rapidly when the market turns against growth. Bernstein has been examining unprofitable tech stocks over the past 50 years. Many of them sported price-sales ratios of more than 15, and the firm concluded that they're likely to lose, on average, 30% of their value, with the most acute losses concentrated in the most richly valued tech stocks as determined by price to sales. In essence, the momentum that has propelled tech stocks to sky highs is losing force as economic conditions worsen. In October, the U.S. economy started showing signs of depressed growth. In this final quarter, retail sales have been disappointing as shortages and rising prices leave consumers with fewer choices and inflation affects consumers' purchasing power. The emergence of a new virus variant does not help the overall picture. Travel restrictions are being reintroduced all over the world, and lockdowns may compromise global manufacturing and add pressure on already stressed supply chains. This turn could have an impact on investor sentiment and lead to a global reaction on stock markets and even show up in companies' results this quarter. None of this is good news for overvalued stocks. With interest rate hikes right at the corner and a stagnant economy, the outlook for growth is considerably reduced. A bear market is required at this point, said Dennis Gartman, the University of Akron endowment chairman. The Fed clearly will be tightening monetary policy rather than being as expansionary as it has been, and stock prices are probably headed, the best that one can say is, get the trend right. And I think that the trend is now to the down, not the upside, he explained. We had an expansion for a long period of time, And I think over the course of next year, he or she who loses the least amount of money will be the winner, Gottman highlighted. Top-tier investors seemingly agree with his view. Only in the past week, a whopping $43.2 billion was allocated into cash as players run from risky assets and look for ways to protect their wealth. Even Bank of America's Michael Harnett is warning that the recent weakness in equity markets, in addition to speculation, leverage, liquidity, and the yield curve lead indicator all signal that an aggressive Fed intervention is coming. The bubble in speculative froth has popped, Harnett noted, and it's leading to epic tech divergences. It's time for a wake-up call. After almost a decade of near-zero interest rate policy, massive amounts of liquidity and financial support, the market has become detached from reality. But that bonanza is close to an end. Put it simply, valuations are merely the mathematical representation of investor psychology. During the peak of each cycle, investors want to believe that this time is different, whether because of alternative fundamentals, economic perspectives, or monetary interventions. Unfortunately, it never is. However, today's valuations reflect investor greed, and other measures stress the growing disconnect between the market and well-established realities. As the chief investment strategist of Real Investment Advice, Lance Roberts, has recently explained, one of the most fundamental disconnects currently is between stocks and the economy. Historically, when stocks have deviated from the underlying economy, the eventual resolution is lower stock prices. With earnings disappointing, some stock prices already readjusted by 65% to realign with weaker than expected profits and slower future earnings growth. Last week, we could already observe a significant crash in oil prices, small cap stocks, and crypto as inflation-induced taper tensions gained force. Stocks are not the economy, but the economy is a reflection of the very thing that supports higher asset prices, corporate profits, stressed Roberts. That means that even though the market rally might have defied logic, fundamentals and our economic reality, those are the only things that matter in the long term. Optimism is blinding some investors who are failing to see that the main support that drove the market higher over the past 2 years will not be there to support economic expansion and growth anymore. The risk of disaster is high, and so will be the price to pay for being willfully blind to the dangers.